All right. If anyone wants to find that, post it in the thing, and then everyone can tier whore off of matchups. But
exactly.
So looks like okay. Arcana, he's been going a lot of Game & Watch today. I don't think I've seen a Zero Suit.
I don't think that this is Game & Watch.
Oh.
I think that this is port priority.
Okay.
Fun fact, Arcana does actually play this character.
He does. He played him in doubles. Oh,
the apple. Nobody gets it. If only that was like the apple from Green Greens.
That just like a straight up throwable apple.
Throwable and then apple just, that just like kills you at 30%.
Gosh. The freaking hidden tech skill AGTing. AGTing, yes. The apple just all across
AGT
the stage.
The apple.
New tech. Yes.
That would be great. Are you actually invincible during the AGT?
You get like some of your air dodge frames, I think.
Right.
But other than that, no, you shouldn't be.
So for anyone who doesn't know, AGT is aerial glide tossing, which is sort of a flavorful take from glide tossing in Brawl, where you could roll and throw an item at the same time. You cannot do that in Project M, but you can air dodge and throw an item at the same time.
Mm-hmm. And it does allow you in order to like act after it. Usually the air dodge will put you in a stun state, but
right.
If you AGT it, then you get the little bit of direction, and then you get to throw your item up, or whichever direction that you want to, actually. And then you can act after it. So a lot of Lynx and Toon Lynx, you'll see them use AGT in order for recovery.
Yep, and even Snake can do it with his grenades.
Oh, yeah.
Although we don't see Messi do that very often.
No. Oh, that was a scary situation.
Yeah.
We had the down smash.
Oh, and Messi.
Oh, Messi. Messi, no.
Messi killed himself. He had already gotten the sticky on to Arcana, so he couldn't use it to save himself there.
Ooh, but he gets it again.
Wow, that was a great tech chase into Stick there.
Oh, yes. And Stick.
Boom.
Buff. This patch. It's
yes,
a lot quicker.
It's faster now, Messi was telling me.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah, I actually saw him do some crazy stuff. I saw him playing against a space animal. He was able to get a stick and an up air and then blow up the sticky.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when I was playing him, he did up B at a shield, stick, up B.
Yep.
I'm like, okay, Messi. Sure. Why not? You're Snake.
Yep. And this matchup has historically been difficult for Messi. Arcana is just really got his number. They've played for a long time. They were both Brawl players.
Yes.
Before playing in PM.
Oh, yes.
And Arcana went by level 0 back then and played Fox mostly.
Interesting. The more you know. I did not know that.
So these guys have been playing each other since before PM existed.
Mm-hmm. Must be interesting to play like at that high level.
Right. While, two different games.
Yeah. And then just seeing each other go back and forth that power shield.
Yeah.
Oh, that was beautiful.
Ooh,
oh, there we go.
Nice.
Using his stuff against him. Good job on that. Good
yep.
mindset. Arcane is such a smart player.
Yeah.
Ooh. In terms of player skill, this seems pretty even.
Yep, and Arcana has the added bonus of not really being surprised by Snake stuff, because Snake was a pretty good character in Brawl.
Yeah, very true. Messi did play Snake in Brawl,
Messi
as far as I know. So.
Messi did play Snake in Brawl.
And a lot of the physics carried over. Ooh, if he just held it a little bit more.
And second time that's happened.
Yep. I feel like that was a little flub right there.
That was almost an awesome 40% kill. Wow, and Arcana, without fast falling, is actually sort of messing up Messi's timing.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, good jump right
Arcana
there.
Arcana just jumped barely in time there.
Yeah, great awareness right there. Oh, that could have been an up B, and that could have been something cool.
Yes.
Decides not to go for it. Ooh, intangible bullet.
Oh, it kind of gets back on.
Almost. Yeah.
It's just
he's not dead,
that
and that's
yep.
the important part. It
took, I don't know, 15%, something like that, to get back on.
Yeah.
That's fine. This is a stock up. Might take this. game without losing that stock.
Messi.
Especially if Messi does that. Gotta pay attention to how many tranks he used each stock. Ooh, the duelist.
Such good aim with that. Yeah, you can kind of go down, do a thing, and then just
get
re-grab.
Back up. Yep. A couple of different methods that you can do to deal with that tether, each with its own benefits and drawbacks.
Drops the sticky.
And
beautiful.
He's got a full set of tranks. He's at 170, so he can't even really use the grenade to kill himself or to save himself.
Nope.
Arcana did. Takes the first game.
Yes. Nessie, rage quitting.
Yeah, before he dies off the top.
And we are back to Smashville.
CSS can't really kill off the top very well either. So dying off the top, not a very common sight.
Nope. Yeah, she usually hits outward or downward with
Forward smash, or back air, or forward air.
Yep. Up B.
She actually has the hardest time killing up out of any character in the cast.
I believe it. Here we go.
Up smash doesn't kill upwards.
Here's what I was hoping to see a little bit more from Arcana, was using a little bit more up Bs whenever he can't reach him.
Yeah. Ooh. That back air was massive. Messi's going to have to blow himself up. And the grenade is going to save him, but he takes extra damage, he has to attack, he's at 160.
I think he was at what, like 90 when he first got off?
Yeah, I mean, and he's alive, which is good.
Yeah, I mean, all that matters is those little stock icons.
Yeah, and Snake can deal a lot of damage, even at a really high percent. But the likelihood that he's going to take this stock first.
The backswing?
The backswing.
Ooh, there we go. No, it does not.
It will combo fast fallers, though.
Interesting.
So you can actually, if they're stuck against the ledge, you can charge a forward smash and it catches every single one of their options.
Beautiful fair right there by Messi.
Yeah.
Evening it up.
And
beautiful follow-ups by Arcana right there.
That down smash leading into so much damage.
Oh, I like that idea of the down smash, but somehow it grabbed.
Yeah. Ooh. Snake got another little buff. It's a lot easier for him to hit his sweet spots on up air and back air now.
Yes.
They are a bit larger.
Very much so. I think they reversed on where the sweet spots were. Is that correct?
I don't know about that. I just know that the patch notes said that it is easier to hit them now.
Okay. I thought that like that's how they did it was by
I haven't labbed it up that hard yet.
Okay.
So.
Fair enough. If someone wants to confirm that they can.
Paralyzer all day long.
Dude, why not? Ooh. Oh, that's why. That's why you don't.
It's slow and easy to power shield.
Yeah.
Mm. And that is faster and harder to power shield and invisible. It's like trying to power shield Cheeks and Needles.
Yeah.
Except that when you mess up, you die.
Yep. Because, like, you'll power shield one, and then,
and then
the rest will hit you.
Yeah, it's so horrible.
It's like, great, thanks.
Thanks, game. Cheek Needles.
Yeah.
We could talk the entire night about just that.
Cheek Needles.
Cheek Needles.
I'm going to Smash 4 Cheek Needles. Customs?
Oh,
Electric
really?
Needles.
Oh, man. I don't know anything about that.
Fun and fast-paced, that's what it means.
Great addition to the game.
Yeah.
Oh, yep, and Arcana just knows to stay in the air in those situations so that doesn't happen. Otherwise, that happens.
Mm-hmm.
And Arcana's finding himself down here a little bit. And maybe a little bit farther down than we thought.
Oh, yes.
Ooh.
Doesn't quite get the gimp right there, but
ooh,
good dodging
on
that. Oh, and Messi SDs.
Yeah, you tried to throw the grenade up there for something, but no. It's kind of like the Yoshi throw an egg last ditch.
Yeah.
You don't really want to do that.
Yeah. The spacey gangster lasers. Just gonna like, snipe you as I die.
I'm going to jump up and shoot a couple lasers as I die.
Yeah.
Hope that you aren't shielding.
Yeah.
Ooh, almost. And the Cypher into up air isn't quite going to finish it. But Messi in a good spot here.
Oh, yes. 100.
And he's actually going to get away with that.
Wow. Got a fresh set of tranks right there.
That reload takes forever. I've seen people charge smash attacks all the way because he did that in their face. The funnest is when he did that. He would used to do that to Just all the time. So Ike's just charging a forward smash, and you
go
see
up,
and you see Messi's just like shaking his head as it's happening. because you've got like enough time to think about all the things you've ever done wrong in your life before you die.
It's like, this is what I've done. I did this to myself. I need to go rethink my life.
Right?
Quit Smash forever.
Pretty much. Boom. If only there was enough time to like fully charge Neutral B or something.
Gosh. That would be such garbage.
That would be great.
We're going back to Smashville, game three. They really are Brawl players.
Yes. In fact. Starting out pretty intense here. They're going in.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Messi got the first huge hit. He doesn't convert off of it.
No. Power shields, though. But Arcana's getting used to these power shields that you can just kind of work around them.
Okay. The fully charged paralyzer is really slow. Arcana can usually react before comes all the way back.
Hear the little boom.
Yep, and the small ones have so little hit stun.
Yeah, that it doesn't really matter.
The power shield isn't gonna like lead into huge damage.
Oh yeah,
most of the time.
Beautiful wave dash, and then just kind of drop back air.
Arcana finding that sweet spot back air for the first stock. And the mash out. Brawl players and their mashing skills.
It's pretty good.
Years of playing against ice climbers.
Oh, the quick stock finish off by Messi right there. Just kind of throw him right into the...
Ooh, Arcana with the...
Interesting.
Great.
I can't really tell if that was good or bad for Messi, because he got a little bit of extra damage right there, but also...
I think it was pretty bad, because usually Zero Suit can't get anything off of that.
Off of...
throws, so Arcana with
forward throw into offstage?
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough.
Like...
F-tilt?
I mean, sometimes you just F-tilt someone and they die.
You're not Ganon.
Man.
There we go.
Nice power shield. I actually was telling Messi right before we started a couple of fun things. He was worried about playing Falco, so I told him if you try to power shield and then wave dash out of your shield, you will either power shield it and hit them, or you will shield it and then you will wave dash towards them. And those are really good things to do against Falco lasers, so I think he's doing that a little bit here.
Interesting.
Also, dropping your shield is a little bit faster than wave dashing out of it for most characters. So if they happen to be close enough that you can just drop your shield.
Yeah, just like drop jab or something like
right,
that.
Right, but they're far enough away that you can't grab, so like drop shield down tilt or something.
Yeah.
Snake's down tilt is massive.
Oh, yes it is. His crawl, or his crouch, is just so... low as well.
Yeah,
like it can't get caught by a whole bunch of stuff. So
yeah, we've already seen Messi use that to get away from some paralyzers.
these little gun trades—they're not working out too well in Arcana's favor.
Yeah, no, one of those guns does more most of the time.
Yeah,
but you're both on the ground.
Yeah.
Ooh, ledge cancel dive kicks.
Ooh.
And very nice little string there by Messi.
Oh, yes.
Gonna
get I like that. I never noticed in the animation, like, as like he was like switching out, that like he like drops the cartridge
and then
falls at his feet and then it just poofs.
And it disappears, yeah.
That's cool.
You got a bunch of little cool things.
Yeah. So much detail put into this game. I love it.
Then he, oh my gosh, okay. Almost. Arcana almost has D's.
Oh.
And he's trying to again. Calm down, Arcana.
Showing off some cool movement things.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, and he gets the balloon. Super important. One day we'll have a balloon counter.
Yeah. Someday. I've been telling Dan and Joe for years. Well, not years, because I haven't known them. I don't know if I've known them for multiple years.
They certainly
yet,
haven't been streaming for years yet. So.
Yeah, it's very true.
I have known
both
of them for quite some time. Ooh, and the grenade. Wow, I thought the grenade was just going to end it.
Yeah, dude,
but,
I would have gotten
this is a battle of attrition right now, right?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Two more grenades, and Arcana's done. Although that may be a stock.
Ooh!
He's going to have to blow himself up in Duelist, and he does, but he gets up-aired.
I don't know if he's coming back from that. He missed the stage.
Yeah. And Arcana hit him.
Hands.
Arcana hit him, but it was too far into the hit stun to
to matter.
To do the yeah.
All right, F tilt.
To do the knockback.
Quick 1-2
change. I forget exactly how many frames you have, but if it's only right as the knockback starts that you can negate whatever knockback is happening with your move.
Interesting. Okay. I thought that it was just kind of like if
a lot of the time if anything got hit.
Yeah, so for the first little bit, if someone's a knockback and then you hit them with a move, they just take the knockback from the new move. Mm. But if they're already in knockback from a move for a while and they get hit, it just adds that trajectory to whatever is going on already.
Oh, unfortunate SD from Messi right there.
Killing himself really quick. But this is one of the stages where ZSS can kill herself too. If she gets stuck on that little lip underneath the stage, her up B won't grab the ledge.
Oh, yes.
Which is really obnoxious.
Yeah, that's a pretty huge issue on for a lot of tether characters. I remember back in 3.5, Olimar, it happened to me all of the time, and it made me so sad.
Yeah.
I'll just be like right next to the ledge, I'm like, I'm gonna tether!
Wow, that string
and
was
then
great.
I didn't tether.
Messi almost completely making up for that SD here.
Yeah, only a 55% difference, so let's see if Messi can bring it back. But right now it is currently in Arcana's favor.
Yes.
As ooh. Keep going. Ooh! It's kind of the general tech area, but not quite. Ooh, nice. I like it.
Okay.
I like it.
Hey, Mikey. And Arcana going out there for that one.
And ooh.
Really nice. Yeah, Messi saw that one coming and just DI'd away. He's like, I don't want you to get anything more off of that except for the explosion.
Mm-hmm. Arcana, he's taking what he can get in this game. He noticed that Messi SD to stock, and he's like, I'm going to ramp this up.
Oh, yeah.
And take this entire game. I'm looking for the entire set, I'm sure, off of that SD.
Yeah. Win this game, have some huge momentum going into the last game.
Yes.
But Messi wants to calm that down, show that he's ready for Paragon.
Ooh. Nice little flashy back air right there.
Because, I mean, both of these players actually beat Mewtwo King when he came out here for Revelation.
Indeed.
In Project
yes.
M.
Yes.
So
Mewtwo King got, like, fifth or something like that for
yeah,
that?
It so. was. He was only in the money in Melee, actually. Or no, so he only won Melee.
Yeah.
He was in the money for several games.
But yeah. The sticky is just straight up on Zero Suit's face.
Yes, absolutely.
Ooh, there
and
we go.
Now it's not.
Now it's not.
Yeah, in Brawl, that sticky would actually change players. So if your body collision went through somebody else's, it would switch. It's like a game of hot potato.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. I knew that there was the item that did that, but I didn't realize that the regular C4 did that.
Yeah, Snake C4 in Brawl would also do that.
Huh.
But not in Project M. Once you got that stuck on you, it's just there, on your face, until he explodes it. Literally exploding your face off. So, let's see what we've got. Ooh!
Ooh,
and up air, yeah,
nice.
She cannot kill off the top.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, that second one is going to bring this to the last game here.
Mm-hmm.
Well, unfortunately for Messi. Fortunately for Arcana.
Yes, very much so.
See some,
he was definitely able to take that SD.
Almost saw the Justin Bailey. That outfit is something else. Like, it's definitely, I like that it doesn't look great because the Justin Bailey was for, like, the SNES.
Mm.
That was when that Metroid was out.
Yeah.
So the fact that it doesn't have incredible graphics makes perfect sense to me. It just happens that it's I don't know, I don't find it aesthetically pleasing despite
no,
that.
No, I don't really think that it is, but Arcana likes it.
That, like, putrid green hair and the bright green, or sorry, the bright pink jumpsuit.
Yep.
I can't deal with that. Like, I would probably just forfeit against anybody who picked that against me. Just so you
can't
know.
Can't even look at you.
The nice thing is that no matter what stage they pick, you can see her. She cannot disappear into the background of any stage.
Oh, yes.
With putrid green hair and a bright pink jumpsuit. It's not happening.
3, 2, 1, go!
All right, so last game here is going to be on Delfino's Secret, a really awesome reimagination of the Dracula's Castle
yes.
stage.
For those who don't know, there are actually quite a few little, like, good Easter eggs on this stage.
Yeah, in the background there.
Yeah, the most notable one is if you pause, go all the way behind the wall in the background, there's the paintbrush that Bowser Jr. uses from Mario Sunshine. So can't remember some of the other ones.
Yeah, there's a bunch of stuff.
Yeah,
check out the stage.
Yeah.
It's worth it.
There is a Shine Sprite.
Yes.
In this stage.
And not the super obvious
yeah.
shine that you see right there.
Yes. Yeah, not the one in the glass case right there. It's another small one. Which I really like everything that they put into this game. It just looks so great.
Ooh, with a full forward smash. That's like doing all of Marth's Dancing Blade.
Yeah. Yeah, no one does that.
Except for Ken. And it works.
So why not?
Right? Like, he'll only stop doing it if it stops working, so.
It'll trip people up.
Yep.
And people just won't know what to do against it. Right. Here's what you do. You crouch cancel it.
Crouch cancel.
At literally any percent.
Crouch cancel and mash it down till.
Yeah. 999? Nah, man. Just crouch cancel it. It's fine.
Ooh. Nice.
Aim right there by the little sniping snake right there.
Yep. Gets him off. Messi just using that C4 to get a free recovery, which was a fine use.
Oh, yeah. And he was getting some damage. He was training some as he was going, so. All right, he's out of Trunks.
Yep, he's not quite done yet. Great DI. Brawl DI.
It's toying with him.
Some fake explosions there. There we go. Still can't kill off the top. Just kills off the side.
Yeah, exactly.
CSS just, like, cannot kill off the top.
Nope. But the thing is, as Messi does that, whenever like he's trying to like fake out the C4 explosion, he's got to be careful. And Arcana was able to punish him on this.
Yeah.
Was because since it puts you in your animation, so like you limit your options. You are literally stuck.
Yeah, you're stuck in that animation. For a while.
Ooh, there we go. We got some shields on that.
Yeah, and if you're gonna do the feint, you gotta mix in the real one once in a while.
Yeah.
When it isn't free.
Is that grenade?
I think four
looks sticky, yeah.
Which is now sitting on the ground over there. Okay, it's gone. And up B? No. Just an up air, and he does get up
the top.
At 160!
Yeah! Woo! At the very top of the ceiling as well.
Yeah, up air to him after a double jump at 160.
Pretty sure he had to use the down B for that too.
Yeah.
There. Metal. That
ninja. Oh man. Speaking of, I wish they could have gotten the voice actor again for Phantom Pain, but oh well. Anyway.
Back to the match.
Yes.
We got Arcana in the lead.
Doing some stuff here. Ooh, and that was the second grapple, but it was pretty free.
Doing some shenanigans.
But up B doesn't quite get the forwarder afterwards.
Mm-hmm. And I want to say this is pretty doable for Messi still.
Yeah,
as
114 isn't crazy
for Snake,
especially on a huge stage like this.
Ooh, yeah, there we go. Notices that back air is not gonna. I don't think that it would happen. But good measure.
Yeah.
He was at like 150. That's fine.
Yeah, right. It's just over at that point. Yeah.
But
ooh,
now
the
Messi
full hit of
really
down
gotta,
air. Ooh, yes.
Messi's really got to mind his space right now in this. So.
Okay. Intangible darts. In one of the versions, Samus' fully charged paralyzer was also intangible.
That's scary. That's scary to think about.
And that's not quite. 159 is not 160. I'm afraid that is not enough.
No.
But 180 is probably enough.
Ooh, there we go.
He's dead. Oof. And a really close, really good winner's finals there. Messi is still not happy with that.
No.
So we're going to see some losers matches now.